Thanks so much, Michaela. We are outside. Yeah, the young boys, baseball boys of Cranston Western recently made headlines with a great run at the Little League World Series, and they join us this morning. Congratulations, guys. Everybody here in Rhode Island and everybody on the Rhode Show is very proud. Coaches, Gary Bucci is here. Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you.
Thanks so much for coming in. Introduce your other, you got your assistant coaches here as well.
Jim Demers is to my right, and Larry Lepore is to my left.
What has this experience been like for all three of you guys? You get into this, you know, you get into coaching and training a bunch of young guys to go and play baseball, never probably thinking in the back of your head, you're going to get this far.
Well, Larry had been there, and we can talk about that later, but it was, you know, it was on my bucket list, if you will, and it's been a tremendous experience. I'll have memories of a lifetime, and, you know, we'll always be a part of Cranston Western Little League history. So,
You really, as you go along, as you coach, you really get a special relationship with all these guys. You really get to know all of these guys. What is that like for you?
No, like I said, I was there in 1996 when we won the national championship, and that was a surreal moment. But to ever do it again 19 years later was pretty spectacular with this group of kids.
As an assistant coach, you're standing there, you get to walk out onto that field. Do you get goosebumps when you head out there?
Every single time I went out there, it was amazing. It was just a blast, and, you know, the three of us have been coaching these guys for a while, and it was just me and the two coaches say every day to each other, can't believe we're here. The whole time we were there, it was just an amazing experience.
Two boys on the team,
and I have two boys on the team, yeah, which made it even more,
which is even a better experience.
Yeah,
it's a, you know, father and son experience that many, you know, parents never get to have. Do you pinch yourself when you're out on that field or when you see your boys out on that field?
I didn't really pinch myself, but yeah. It was pretty exciting. Yeah, it was good.
For you guys, we had spoken to the girls last week. Obviously, the TV cameras are here today. TV cameras have been around you, you know, for the past couple of weeks. Are you getting used to this experience? Because the girls were kind of over it.
Yeah, we've been getting used to experience because we've been doing it since Bristol, and we've been getting interviews and stuff in states too. So we got used to it.
All right, now a couple of you guys made it to ESPN. Who's this? You made it to ESPN. You made it to ESPN. Oh, you are right over here. I'm sorry. What was that like for you to see yourself? I mean, you want to play this game all the time, and then you make it to the big leagues. How was that?
I mean, it was great. I mean, you're on ESPN top 10, so you know you're like the best play in the nation. So.
Right.
It's cool.
And for you?
It was just amazing because it's been my dream to make it on top 10, and I finally did it. So.
And there you are. All right. So for all of you guys, what is next for this? What's next for this team?
Well,
he says with a chuckle.
Back to school. Back in our own beds and our own showers was nice. But anyway, the majority of these kids, other than two of them, will move on. They'll go to the big field. You know, they'll play. You know, major league distances, if you will. There are two kids that are on this team that will be back in Little League, which is great for us. And hopefully, you know, there's a lot of kids on this team that clearly have high school and college potential. Mm-hmm. So remember some of these names, and I think you'll be reading about them down the road.
And really, coming in second place is an amazing thing, and that's not even overusing the word amazing. What sort of life lessons did you want these guys to take away about obviously playing and about great sportsmanship?
Now, this is memories that they're going to have for a lifetime. You know, they bonded together with us and their teammates, and I really don't think it's sunk into them yet, but somewhere down the road, a few years from now, they'll realize how special this was and what they accomplished.
We had also spoken to the girls last week about the friendships that have developed through this. What have you seen as a parent and as an assistant coach?
Well, just the friendships they developed at the dorms. You know, the kids were all hanging around with the kids from other countries, Japan, Australia, just incredible. I mean, at times and quite often, they didn't speak the same language,
right,
but they still communicated somehow.
Well, it was great stuff, and guys, we are also very proud of you. Welcome back home to Rhode Island. A great year of school, a great year of baseball. Back to you.